discussed if you can lay your hand on the chest, somebody's up here, you would be absolutely surprised at how many people argue right here in your face. And when they do, if you can get a hand right here, you got good clean uppercuts and elbows. You got follow-through elbows. If your hands are hanging by your side, this is natural. You don't have to get way down here to hit a guy in the jimmy. All right, you just stand here like this. Your hands are right there. You can either flip him, which will cause him to buckle or react and get you set in for an elbow shot and maybe a front headlock, or turn your palm straight up. One of the ways I like to hit the groin is to turn my palm up just like this and just hit just like that. When you hit, they're going to bend, and then you run straight up into their head and rip and turn and tear their head around. This is simple. You can go into the chin, you can go into the eyes, or you can come into the neck and trach him right in it. And remember, this windpipe is a lethal blow. So when that's happening, somebody's in here going, yap, 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 boom, get a shot here. They bend up into their throat, grab and twist, turn. And if you want, you can add another headbutt in here. You want to try to attempt to use your head like a battering ram. These are down and dirty street fighting techniques that work. Other things that will happen frequently, if I ever get into a fisticuff, if I'm going backwards or something, almost always I try to throw my thumb, and I like to use my thumb into their eye. I like to take it and twist it and turn it, and that will give you an advantage to set up other techniques. If you end up on the floor and the guy's out wrestling you, if he's beating you, you just go straight into his eyes, and he's not going to sit around there wrestling you anymore. He's going to get up and get away. And in some cases, they'll even pass out. So it's okay to get into the eyes on these people.